Hello everyone, and welcome back to the important logistics session. This is important because we are totally deviating from our traditional method of payment. We actually used to finance the participants to come and take part in the workshops, but from this workshop onwards, this is of course an experiment at this point. We will be asking the participants to actually come in to pay and attend the workshops. So in that most important aspect, this workshop is going to be very, very unique. So I see a lot of familiar faces here, but there are also some new centers who have joined us this time. New people, new centers. Have you all taken part in our workshops before? But you as a workshop coordinator, okay. So all of you have, all your colleges have taken part in this mission before. Okay, great. That makes my work easy. So this is the outline of my talk today. Professor Kannan Moudgalya this morning has already given you a little bit of history and an outline of the project already. I'm going to be sharing just a few statistics with you. Then we're going to talk about the logistics for the main workshop and all the other aspects which are equally important. So this is actually the title of our project in the ministry. It's the empowerment of students and teachers through synchronous and asynchronous instruction. It was initiated in 2009, as Professor Moudgalya told you this morning. And in 2013, we scaled up to train up to 10,000 teachers at a time. And now IIT Kharagpur is also our partner institute. So far, we have conducted about 26 workshops on various engineering topics. And I'm very happy and proud to say that they've been attended by over 90,000 participants so far, and have been distributed across 353 centers. You all know that these two roles are very, very important at the remote centers, the remote center coordinator and workshop coordinator. In this particular workshop, it's going to be slightly different. I'll come to the point in a minute. We will be, of course, using AVU. When they actually, with the participants actually come to your centers, we will be using AVU, and that's the ICT framework which has been developed by Amrita University. And we will also be using Moodle, just like the earlier workshops. So what is new in the model now? The new model was decided in November last year. We had invited all the remote center coordinators to for a one-day meeting here, and it was decided that we have to move towards some model of self-finance. The government cannot go on financing teachers across the country to come and attend courses. It is in the end self-destructive. So we decided that at least we will start with one workshop on a topic which is common to a lot of, which is common across all the disciplines that are taught in an engineering institute. And it was decided that we will move towards self-finance, where the remote centers as well as the participants finance themselves to conduct a workshop which is actually relayed from IIT Bombay. So the expenses will have to be completely borne by the remote centers and the participants. Since many of you had in that meeting brought up the concern that it a 10-day workshop is perhaps too much for a remote center to bear the cost of, so we decided that we will use a blended kind of a format where the participant does most of the activity online and 5 or 6 days of activity at the actual remote center. So that is how we're going to be blending the two activities. And we're going to be using IIT Bombay X. This is the platform, as Professor Moudgalya told you in the morning. Our team has developed here from the Open edX platform, and we have been using it for our MOOC courses. So we will be primarily using IIT Bombay X and Moodle. Professor Sundar, I'd like you to add in here. There is going to be activity for you all also on IIT Bombay X, since you all also may not be very familiar with this particular platform. So we have decided that,
So as I said, there's the online part and the offline part. The online part, there will be the IIT Bombay X. So for the teachers, okay, I'll call you for the terminology, you are the coordinators and they are the teachers. For the teachers, they definitely have to do the IIT Bombay X, and then they will come to your remote centers. Now here, whatever you are being exposed to is only a gist of what will come in IIT Bombay X and in the December workshop. But since you are not completely exposed to all the activities, and when they come in December, you wouldn't have seen what is that they have undergone in IIT Bombay X. We require that you also enroll yourself as students in the IIT Bombay X course. So far as the online content for 5 weeks that will happen from October, you will also be considered as a student of that course. Okay, so you will be enrolling for IIT Bombay X and completing that like the way the other teachers would be doing it. Okay, just as the other teachers will enroll there, you will also enroll there as a student in that course. And we have a certain pass criteria, which is very minimal. Like all these graded assignments, all these assignments will be graded in the online, but very simple things, right? And I said you'll have this Moodle-based assessments, peer evaluation, and so on. Now, all that will carry some marks, okay? So let's say the whole of online portion, IIT Bombay X plus Moodle, carries 100 marks, the pass mark will be something like 40%, okay, which is very less, there's only pass or no pass. 40%, but 40% in everything. It's not that you get 20 in one and 80 in another, okay? So you need to tell your teachers who come there that they need to attempt everything, but even if they just pass, because it's hard, it's just impossible to fail all those things, because there'll be multiple ways to attempt it again and improve the scores. It's the question is not to evaluate your understanding, but it's just to it's not to give marks that way, grade on that. Just that you become more familiar with the topic, you'll have multiple attempts to attempt it and improve the marks. So it is not a question of like the typically we do in classes. It's not the way that we want you to get one attempt and that's your mark. It's not that. So it's going to be an iterative way that you can improve. And what you need to impress upon the teachers who come there is this, that there is this notional cutoff of 40%, which they have to score in every week of the assignment. So we have 5 weeks, and every 5 weeks on all the assignments, they have to get minimum. So similarly for you, the completion would be, because you have been exposed to the tutorial part, not entire thing completely, and some of the online part, you will also have to register for the IIT Bombay X platform as part of this. So there are a lot of new concepts that are coming here in the over these 2 days. So you feel free to talk to us anytime. This evening session is usually dedicated to this kind of logistical aspects for you to know as coordinators. The morning session is typically for the content which goes through. Evening sessions are mainly for the coordinator work, what are the things that you need to do. So please feel free to talk to us anytime and clarify all these points. It'll be nice, we'll also have an open session on the final day where many more questions you can address. So now this, there are two certificates that are given for you as coordinators. One certificate is for attending this workshop, which is a CEP certificate. So IIT Bombay has got something called as a continuing education program, and people who come to IIT Bombay to participate in workshops get a certificate from IIT Bombay known as from the continuing education department. So it's a CEP certificate. The other certificate, which is an IST,
right? IST, sir.
IST certificate, which is written there, right? What is this? This one, this logo, Society for Technical Education. So that certificate, which the teachers will get, the teachers will get, you will also get, okay? Because you have attended this and you also attended the MOOC. So the teachers get it because they attended, teachers will get only if they attend the MOOC, okay? And they come for the December. If they do only one of them, they are not going to get, okay? So you are getting it because you are coming here and you are also doing the this one. So you will get two certificates, one from IIT Bombay for coming for this 5-day event. Second, for the communication, technical communication, this one, you will get a certificate for doing this and that, the MOOC part, okay? IST part, yeah.
Later, please. So it goes without saying that the online activity is mandatory for everybody here, okay? So this will be the logistics for the self-sustained model. We will be advertising the workshop shortly. And registration, we have decided on a tentative date, 4th September. You will all get the soft copy of the brochure as usual. We will have the online registration at the IIT Bombay NME ICT website. I have put an asterisk there because I am going to come back to that particular point a little later on. The remote center coordinator of your remote center will be given an interface to fill in details of seating capacity, food and accommodation cost at RC, okay? Again, I will be explaining this a bit more in detail later on. The remote center coordinator has to fill in data for seating capacity, accommodation if your remote center is offering it, and an approximate per day cost of the food. This will be applicable only for the self-sustained model. This particular logistics session is only for technical communication because it's a self-sustained workshop, okay? Approximate per day cost of the accommodation if you are offering it, and we are going to be making this information visible to the participants during the registration. In the coordinators meeting, we had decided on a fee of 1000 rupees, participation fee from verified participants. And this will be inclusive of both online and the face-to-face components. It does not include accommodation and any meals or refreshments that you might be going to offer. And it has to be collected before the first component begins. We'll tell you how. There is a two-step registration process for the participants. The participants will register on the IIT Bombay NME ICT website. They will be asked to submit a proof of their, employment and also permission letter from their heads of the institute. As again, it's a usual procedure, and through that we will verify them, and we will put up the verified participants list on our website, and we will ask them to contact the remote center coordinators of the remote center of their choice. Then they will pay the registration fee to the remote center, and only then, and we will also provide an interface to the remote center coordinator to confirm that participant if that person has paid. So now the onus is also upon you. So far it was only IIT Bombay which used to be, you know, confirming the participants and things like that, but since there is another component of fees involved here which will go to the remote centers, we are going to be involving the remote center coordinators as well. Once the verification and the payment of registration fee is over, the participant is confirmed, and there will be an automatic mail which will go from here to him about the IIT Bombay X platform. He has to register on that, and the workshop coordinators will have to monitor that. They'll have to keep track of which participant has not, signed up for the IIT Bombay X. We will then team them onto the technical communication course on the IIT Bombay X platform. There will be a very rigorous testing schedule for AVU. It's exactly the way things happen in the old traditional model. Without AVU, you will not get a good quality of audio video at your remote center. And now you will actually have the participants to answer. Remember that. if they have paid a fee of 1,000 rupees, you'd better make sure that the audio video quality is good. And we will of course be providing Moodle IDs for the participants. You will be given the Creative Commons license and permission slips as usual to take their signatures. And there will be a local registration also. All this I'm talking about the second phase, where they will actually come to your centers. We will be conducting the inaugural and valedictory from IIT Bombay. You are free to invite any local dignitaries if you please. There will be helplines which we will send to you, helplines for everything, for AVU, for logistics, everything. Quizzes will be held on IIT Bombay X and on Moodle. These are the tentative, fixed dates. Online activity on IIT Bombay X will start on 8th October and it will continue till 11th November. And the face-to-face component at remote centers will start from 30th November to 5th December. And post main workshop, there will be a final assignment. And the participant has to complete the final assignment within 2 weeks. And all the assignments, everything is mandatory for a certificate. Please impress this upon your participants. And you as workshop coordinators will be responsible in monitoring the assignment submission. So this is the criteria for certificate. Completion of online assignments on IIT Bombay X, at least 90% attendance during the face-to-face component, and completion of the post-workshop assignment. After the main workshop, we will be distributing the participation certificates, the IIT Bombay X, ISD IIT Bombay X certificates to the participants. And we will also be publishing all the contents that are generated in this workshop in open source. Okay, so we have been trying to make things as simple and as automated as possible for the, for making our website easy to monitor. So I will be asking one of my colleagues here to come and demonstrate to you the interface that we have made for both remote center coordinators and workshop coordinators. There is a certain process that is involved. I request you all to pay attention to her. Kanan.
So, both remote center coordinators and workshop coordinators are supposed to sign up at IITB NMEICT website, which you all have done. That is how you have got registered to this workshop. Very important thing, there are at least 8 or 9 remote centers, remote center coordinators who are also a workshop coordinator. So we have asked them to use 2 different email IDs. So please use the remote center coordinator and a workshop coordinator who are playing the same role. You are requested to use a remote center coordinator email ID when you are going to access a remote center coordinator interface. And obviously your workshop coordinator ID is already with you. So you have to use 2 different email IDs. Even if a remote center coordinator wants to be a participant for any particular workshop, you are requested not to use the remote center coordinator email ID which is given to us. You are requested to use a different email ID, because the interface for remote center coordinator is only, you will be only seeing your remote center coordinator interface pertaining to that workshop. So we'll just see role of a remote center coordinator. You obviously have to log in to IITB NMEICT website with your remote center coordinator ID. The first screen which you will be seeing is workshop attended. Whichever you have attended in the past, you will be able to see those. And also there are 3 other important aspects. One is manage remote center capacity, manage participants, and view participants. This I am right now talking about only remote center coordinator role. So people who are going to play a remote center coordinator role may please pay attention. As soon as the main workshop is announced on our IITB NMEICT website by IIT Bombay, the seating capacity interface, that is the manage remote center capacity interface, will be made live in the remote center coordinator login. Till now, there was a process wherein you used to get a link where you have to fill the required details. But now you will be receiving a link only as a reminders. If you are not filling the remote center capacity, then you will we will be sending out reminders. But otherwise, the moment a main workshop is announced, you will be able to see this remote center capacity module will be activated. What are you supposed to fill? Seating capacity, accommodation available, approximate per day cost for food and accommodation. Please note the two fields, that is approximate per day cost of food and accommodation, is only applicable for the self-sustained model. For the regular funded model, you will not have these two fields to fill in. Okay, you will only have two fields, that is sitting capacity and accommodation. And this interface you will be using for all the workshops, whether it is a self-sustained model or it is a funded model. What if you don't fill the remote center capacity? Participants will not be able to see your remote center in the registration form, and they will not be able to register. So the green points are the ones which are the action points to be taken. Red points, please avoid it, because those are danger points. Okay, once you fill the remote center capacity, you will not be able to update. So for any updation, you are requested to email us at eoutreach@it.iitb.ac.in. I'll just quickly run through the registration process of a participant. So the participant will log into the IITB NMEICT website. They have to see the seating capacity, as in the cost of per day cost of the food and per day cost of the accommodation. Based on this, the participants will choose your remote center. T10 KT team at IIT Bombay will check the permission letters and they will verify the registration. After the registration of a participant is verified, he or she will receive an auto email stating that he has to pay the fees to the remote center coordinator. So how will he come to know who is the remote center coordinator? So in the participant dashboard, we are going to show the email ID of the respective remote center coordinator. So they will contact the remote center coordinator and pay the fees. So what is a remote center coordinator supposed to do? He will get a list of the participants under the tab called Manage Participants. He will get the name of a participant with two buttons, that is Accept and Reject. So the moment he is receiving, a remote center coordinator receives the fees from the participant, you have to just click on Accept. The status of the participant is changed to Accepted. It will not be changed to Confirm. The confirmation will be only done by IIT Bombay T10 KT team after one working day, one or two working days. We will be giving the confirmation to the participants. For every step, the participant would be receiving an auto email. As soon as the participant status is changed to confirmed, the participant will be mapped on Moodle course, that is one. The participant will be mapped on the technical communication course on IIT Bombay X. But the participant is also requested to sign up on the IIT Bombay X. If we only enroll and if the participant does not create an account on IIT Bombay X platform, he or she will not be able to view the course. So that is very important. Suppose if the participant does not turn up or he wants to change the remote center, you can click on Reject button, a dialog box will appear wherein you can write the reasons, and the status of the participant is changed to registration invalid. So in this, the participant can select another remote center, change the remote center, whatever. And if he is not interested, if the participant is not interested in attending the workshop, you have to inform us at IIT Bombay. We will cancel the registration of the participant. So all this activity of accepting and rejecting of the registrations of the participant is done before the online component starts at IIT Bombay X. That means before 8th of October, this activity has to be over. Secondly, till now we used to send the soft copy of attendance sheet, schedule, everything. But now we will not be sending it through emails. The schedule also will be available in the dashboard of a remote center coordinator, a workshop coordinator, and a participant. There is also a provision to download the schedule of the workshop So you are requested to download it from there and print it and give it to your participants. There won't be any emails coming from e-outreach regarding the schedule or attendance or any scan copy of the attendance. Lastly, you can also, after all the registration process is over, you can you can just view your participants through the view participant module. This is the role of a remote center coordinator. Maximum of you are a workshop coordinators. I think only 8 or 9 are the participants who are a remote center coordinator and a workshop coordinator both. So first thing, you have to go back to your remote centers and tell your remote center coordinator that if they have not created their login on IITB NMEICT website, they need to do that at the earliest. Now comes the role of a workshop coordinator. As usual, you have to log in to the website. You will be seeing two different sections. One is workshop attended, whatever your previous workshops and everything. And secondly is manage attendance. Attendance is a part which a workshop coordinator is supposed to take care of. As I said earlier, till now we used to send it through emails, but now there will not be any emails from e-outreach. I am repeating once again, we will not be sending any emails from e-outreach. All the data would be available in your login. You can just fill the data and submit it. So, as I said earlier, you can view the schedule and you can download the schedule. Please, for the printouts, you are requested to download the schedule. The view option is only for yourself, because that the layout of view option is a little difficult. So please do not take a printout of that part. You are requested to download the schedule and then print it. And the attendance format will be only available on the first day of the workshop. That is, in your case, it will be available on 30th of November. So what would you do? You have to download the soft copy of the attendance in which you will take the signature of all the participants. So that you have to do, that is one. Secondly, at the end of the day, you are requested to upload the attendance only in your interface. Please do not email us on e-outreach. Only if there is a problem or something, but I don't think there should be any problem. So you please upload the attendance on your interface. This is only the soft copy part. So basically you are supposed to take two actions. One is downloading the attendance, taking the signature and uploading it. That's why it is highlighted in green. Second is, you will also be getting an interface wherein you have to mark the participant present and absent. So by default, when the page will load, all the participants would be marked absent. It will be an empty checkbox. What you are supposed to do, just check the checkbox and click on update. Please note, if you do not do this in 48 hours, all the participants will be marked automatically absent. And the participants will receive an email that your attendance is not updated by a workshop coordinator. So only 48 hours every day, please do it inevitably. You have to fill this every end of the day. Because the update button in your login for a respective date would be available only for 48 hours. After that, it would be disabled. So the moment if you forget or miss out, your participant will come back to you stating that you have not marked my attendance. So that's why it is given in red, that if you do not fill attendance, it will be a problem for your participants. Okay, so whatever we just said, there is a small demo, and tomorrow we have planned a hands-on session. There will be a flowchart which will be given it to you tomorrow. We have made this website available on some test website, not the actual IITB NMEICT website. So all these things we will brief you tomorrow, and there will be a hands-on session as in how to mark present and everything. For 15 days, this module will be available, and we will monitor from here whether you are updating it or not. So please do practice it so that during the main workshop, at least you do not have a problem handling this module. I'll request my software team to be here and give you a small demo.
Any questions about the self-sustained model?
We are going to send you the seating capacity of our respective RC.
You will not send it to us. There will be an interface. You will fill it on.
Whatever. That. But then, why do we have to give the details of the accommodation if we are not providing it?
So far we have been providing accommodation for the participants. Suppose you have a remote center in a remote area.
Okay.
And somebody is coming from far away to attend the workshop.
Okay.
If you can offer him accommodation, well and good, and he should know how much that accommodation costs.
Okay, but that's not mandatory.
That is paid. That is not, you don't have to pay for it. The participant will pay for it.
Okay, fine.
And also, it is not mandatory for him to take it. It is totally optional. It is optional for you to provide accommodation and food. It is optional for the participant to take it.
It's only for information that will be uploaded.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Is there any financial commitment on our part as a remote center?
You will be taking 1,000 rupees registration fee from your participant, and you have to manage everything in that.
Okay, fine.
You can take as many as you want.
Minimum.
Yes.
It is minimum.
Yes.
There are 20.
That's fine. That's fine. No problem. Even if it is 5, we don't have any problem.
No.
Yeah. We are not providing any money for anybody this time.
This time you are not providing any money.
No.
So we have to conduct that workshop.
Yes. Yes. You have to conduct the workshop.
We have to conduct the workshop, that is mandatory, right?
Yes.
Now those remote. Because it is very difficult to call people to attend this kind of workshop. People.
I have said 5 also.
5 all.
Ma'am, there might be some in the first quarter which were not actually working anywhere, but they will like in the next 2 weeks.
It's who your participants are is your problem.
I mean, there is a lot of people who have been in the length of the year.
Yes, but we will give certificates only to teachers. The certificates from IIT Bombay X will go only to teachers. Our project is concerned only with teachers and not with students. And that includes research scholars, unfortunately.
Is it fine if we don't ask money from them? We get a free, not a problem.
I think Professor Fatak will answer this question on Friday.
Sorry, using up time. This 5-week, it's a serious investment. So as regards faculty members' participation in those 5 weeks, we can possibly ask our director to relieve these faculty members for this.
They are not being released for 5 weeks. They are doing it online.
Yeah,
at
online.
Their leisure. This is 1 week's work equivalent spread across 5 weeks.
Okay, so approximately what kind of, we are looking at an investment in time, right? Because earlier on there was never any 5 weeks involvement.
Yeah, so earlier it was 10 days.
10 days, yeah.
Two weeks time, right? So now that 1 week, that 5 days time, is spread over 5 weeks, but they take it at their leisure. They usually do it at home.
Okay.
So there is, or they do it after hours. So it is every week. They can do it anytime. So the course, I'll tell you a rough schedule of how this happens.
Yeah.
A week begins on a Thursday. Okay. For the purposes of MOOC course in IIT Bombay X, a week begins on a Thursday, which means Thursday at 9 o'clock or 8 o'clock in the morning, about 10 videos will be uploaded. Okay, 10 videos Thursday morning. Now, either on Thursday itself, they can view all, because 10 videos, each is of 10 minutes, okay, each of 10 minute duration. So about 90 to 100 minutes of video per week. Now, as for that, they have to, for every 10 minute video, there will be at least a 10 minute exercise. Okay. A small exercise, like fill in the blanks that the ones I gave you. So 10 minute exercise. And then for the entire week, there might be one or two long assignments, which will take about an hour or two hours or 3 hours at most per week. Okay, so the total time invested for a particular person for a particular week would be 100 minutes of video, 100 minutes of quick assignments, and about 2 to 3 hours of work per week. So they can do it at any time. Okay, now, so as I said, Thursday it starts, and unless they complete this, they cannot go on fast forward and do the next week assignment now. Okay, the next week's assignment will come only on the next week's videos will come only on next Thursday. It's not that everything will be put up first and they can finish it off. It's not going to be that way. So they do for 1 week, and by Wednesday, by Monday, the quiz will be out. I mean, the detailed home assignment, everything will be out. And the next Monday will be the deadline for the assignments they did this week. Okay? And then in that time, they also do the evaluation and so on. So the time is really not that much.
So that 5 days basically has been expanded into 5 weeks.
Exactly. But 5 days, you mean that's an intense 8-hour course per day, right? So this is expanded that way.
And it is not necessary to do it every day.
No, it is up to the teachers. Whenever they want, they can do. Everything they can do in 1 day. The whole thing they can do in 1 day and a weekend and finish it off. What will be the role of workshop coordinators during this online course? Firstly, you have to remember that you yourself have to take part in the online activity. So, apart from that, there is not really much, except that just reminding, because if they are, see, I don't know, most of them might be from your college or onion around, if they come and ask for some help, because you are kind of exposed to little more than them in this workshop, you might want to guide them. But I don't expect a lot of interaction during that time, because you yourself will be busy in doing this. Definitely during the workshop time, you are the local leaders there. So at that time, you have to play important role. But I don't say, because for us also, this is new. There might be some unexpected things, but most of the things we will handle from here. Okay? Because it's online and there is no face-to-face, we should be able to handle most of the things from here.
So any of the difficulties are coming?
Yes, can we communicate
to us?
It is during the 5 days face-to-face component, of course, we will be giving you helplines. But no, we have a dedicated IIT Bombay X troubleshooting team. So they will take care of any software-related problems.
Let's finish this point. So there is, in IIT Bombay X, there is something called as an online discussion forum, where if a person posts, our instructors from here will reply to that and all of you can see it.
Yeah.
Okay. So all of you, not just you, but all the teachers can see that. All the participants of that course will be able to see it. So that generic, if it's a general, some failure, something, all of us will know. But if it's something like how to do a particular thing, we will be able to tell over the discussion forum. Yes, that will be there. Yes,
forum,
I said. Okay. Discussion forum, not phone.
I'm Dr. G.P. Sahu from NIT Allahabad. My question is related to remote center coordinator. Now, if they are organizing the program, is it not possible to provide them a certificate that, you know, similar to workshop coordinator, they get a certificate for coordination? And moreover, IIT Kharagpur is providing that. No, it is not a certificate of participation, but it's a certificate of commendation.
So yes, we do provide. NIT Allahabad hasn't participated for a very long time.
No, we have
in our workshops. So we do provide certificates to remote center coordinators, support staff, everybody.
Okay, so for recently organized program that is on environmental engineering, no, so far you have not sent a certificate.
There is a certain process. All your financial everything is clear, only then you will get.
Okay,
that
fine.
Is why I said you haven't participated for a long time.
Okay. And second question is related to this workshop coordinator. You mentioned that workshop coordinators are also required to register for the online course that is IIT Bombay X. So do you need to pay the money as well? And again, do you require to get a certificate, a sponsorship certificate from the institute? The same, you mentioned about that authorization letter from institute is required to register for the course?
No. So IIT Bombay X is free. Whatever their payment is happening is people are paying to you, the teachers are paying to you in your center, because you're providing some service. IIT Bombay X is free.
That 1,000 rupees is the remuneration fund or workshop
coordinator? Yeah, so you can pay yourself. Yeah.
Two questions.
The second?
About the amount, 1,000 rupees. You said that it is free for the coordinator.
Yes.
Then second is the permission letter. So again, we have to collect a permission letter or it's fine?
IITB NME ICT website, you are already registered. When you came here, you registered on that website. Now you have to register on IIT Bombay X. IIT Bombay X is free for everybody. But for the sake of this particular workshop, we are going to be mapping the registered participants of IIT Bombay NME ICT website onto IIT Bombay X. There are a two-tier registration process. First, the participants will register on the IITB NME ICT website, and then we will map them onto IIT Bombay X. Clear? But you will straight away go to IIT Bombay X and register there.
So
there is no certificate required, no permission letter, no fees, nothing. Even for them to register on IIT Bombay X, there's nothing is required. That is required on IIT Bombay NME ICT website. Okay, when they register on IIT Bombay X, they would have already cleared all that permission letter business. They would have already been verified by us.
Hello, madam.
Yeah, they have to basically sign up on IIT Bombay X. Because we don't have anybody's email IDs, we require them to sign up for IIT Bombay X. Okay?
Hello. Madam, as far as you say that, the fee is 1,000 rupees.
Yeah.
So it includes the food and accommodation or different?
No, it does not include. Yeah. He's asking if this 1,000 rupees includes the accommodation and food. Food and accommodation is totally optional. It does not, this 1,000 rupees does not include anything. It only includes his participation fee. He will be on IIT Bombay X and he will be attending the face-to-face component. These two components, he has to pay 1,000 rupees. Yeah, 1,000 rupees can be used towards your institute overheads. It can be used for payment of say workshop coordinator, remote center coordinator, support staff, electricity bills, for any such utility items.
It is there, it is there.
Yes.
Yes, it is there.
We have already mentioned this, but I'm just refreshing.
Ma'am,
just one moment.
Ma'am, can arts faculty take part in this workshop? Faculty of arts and science colleges.
You're most welcome, except that this certificate,
yeah.
I mean, if you are okay with this certificate, I mean, there is not...
No, I'm asking you whether the participants who come the workshop...
Because they'll also be getting this same certificate from IST.
Okay.
Now, I don't know if that is of value to them, but if it is of value to them, I think they should take it. We are going to recommend, we expected people will come, but what we were not clear from our side is whether people from arts and science colleges, for them this is of any worth. Yeah, so it may not be this one to them, but there's nothing stops them from coming to your center and taking the course.
Yes, sir, thank you.
But if you have arts faculty teaching this particular course in your college, yeah. Then it's a different issue. They are definitely welcome to attend.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes. But even.
Yeah. But suppose.
Arts background.
No. In some colleges, you have a large. They may not belong to an engineering department, right? They come to the maybe university, for example. University's humanities division will come and teach in this. So, as such, it's not of use to them. But it certainly. Yeah, it's up to you. Yeah, any other questions?
At the end of the workshop, do we have to send all the financial details to you? And if no, in such kind of situations, if our institute thinks that, let's make it free for all the participants. Do you have any...
Friday, Professor Fatak. But to answer your first question, you do not have to submit any bills or anything to us.
But do remember you have stakeholders to answer this time. Your participants will catch hold of you. If your audio and video quality is not good, then definitely your participants will ask you to refund their money.
I just wanted to ask, we are charging 1,000 rupees per participant and if we are providing food, so that makes 250 per day per participant. So around we charge them 1,000 plus 250.
The course fee for this particular course is 1,000. You keep your food and accommodation separate. It should not be clubbed together. Registration fee is 1,000, period. So you can provide, that is absolutely optional.
So what you do for, so that they are also clear, you can say something like food coupons. You say that daily food coupons, you come and buy it here and you sell it separately. Make it a separate business than this. This is 1,000 rupees, definitely they have to pay. Now somebody says that, I don't want to take 250 rupees food, I'll go and have canteen food, you should leave them alone. So basically you say that there are food coupons available, you can come and buy it here and go and use it in the canteen for the whole day or something like that. It's one possibility, but just don't combine these both. Yeah, one.
Last time we were conducting the workshop at Pechpur University, Assam. So that for 1 day or 2 days we were dealing. Connectivity was not there. So there was a big problem. So this time, even if it is like that, then you said that within 48 hours we have to do this. And you are saying that participant will catch us.
Yeah. Tejpur had a very specific, very severe problem. We will definitely consider natural disasters. No problem about that. You should catch hold of your workshop coordinator and remote center coordinator. They have not probably completed their formalities regarding funds.
No, but then I sure will have a talk tomorrow and let you know. But what she said was she sent all papers and my Moodle, my registration link shows that you've completed all assignments.
Yes,
so
but
let me see what the matter is like.
I don't know what the fund situation is like.
Fund in the sense we just want our certificates, like.
Yeah, sure, but yeah. Your remote center coordinator has to complete certain formalities.
Okay, but anyway, I'll have a talk again because she said she completed all her process. Let me see. I'll just verify.
Even though if she has sent everything, it has to be checked by us, no? So only after that, yeah.
So what will there be many more questions we'll take? We'll have such sessions every day. So let's go to the demo part now.
Good evening, everyone. So firstly, we will see the remote center coordinator's login. Okay, a person who's a remote center coordinator, if he's not registered with the site, please go and sign up first. After that, login as a remote center coordinator. So once you log in, your home screen will be like this. First, if you have attended any workshops before, you will have the workshop attended dashboard. After that, you will have this remote center coordinator's interface, wherein you see remote center capacity management module and manage participants and view participants. Firstly, let us go to the manage remote center capacity module. You can see a list of workshops wherein you can manage it. Click on 1.3. Previously, the remote center coordinators were receiving the email with a link through which the remote center coordinators fill the capacity and available seats. Now with this module, you have to fill the per day accommodation cost and the food cost, and you just submit the button. So after filling the remote center capacity and the food cost, you will be able to see it again in the home page. So if you see this again, go to the manager details. So you will be seeing the details you have filled. If you want to change this, you have to mail eoutreach at it.iitb.ac.in. This is what a remote center coordinator does at the first. Go back to the home. After filling the remote center capacity, your remote center will be displayed in the main workshop drop down so that people can see what you have filled, the accommodation, the seating capacity, the food and the accommodation cost per day. After that, this self-sustained model has two stages, as explained by Kanan before. You will have to accept the participant if they have paid the fee of the workshop, that is 1,000 rupees, once they are verified already by the Anime City software, like administrator team. After the registration starts and verification is done by the workshop administrator team, you will see a list of participants wherein you can accept or reject. Accept is on like after paying the cost, and reject when the remote center, when the participant doesn't pay. Press on reject. You have to fill the reasons why you are rejecting a participant. After clicking on submit, he will get a mail on why you have rejected him. Send some mail.
It is clear that he hasn't paid.
Is there any other reason also?
Not paid.
He is not interested in the participant wants to change the remote center. Then okay. You have to click on reject. So his registration will become invalid and he can change the remote center.
Yeah, you can write any reason of your choice. And the participant will receive the same email.
Suppose he has already paid money, then what we need to do, and if he wants to change the center?
You can call e-outreach.
Yeah, so if the participant wants to change the remote center, you have to refund the money. And you have to inform us. We at IIT Bombay will first cancel the registration of the participant, and then we will make the registration invalid. So when the status is invalid, always the participant will be able to update his or her registration. So his status has to be invalid. So in that case, you have to let us know which participants wants to change the remote center after the payment of the fees.
So on clicking on accept, he will be accepted and the participant will not be displayed in this list. Once you reject or accept a participant, he will not be displayed in this list. Accept. He'll be disappeared automatically from this list. So this is the added role of remote center coordinator, like accepting or rejecting the participant on the self-sustained model. Now we will see the workshops coordinator login. You're all workshop coordinators. You have to log in with the site with the registered email ID. No, you have registered for the workshop. Now you're logging in as a workshop coordinator. You will see a different dashboard. Now you will see a list of workshops you have attended. Like you can see the schedule of it by clicking on it. So if the workshop is running, you can click on the schedule to see the schedule. Also, a PDF format is available of this for the schedule. You can download it. Go to the home. Yeah. For the ongoing workshop, you just click on the details. You will see the list of participants available. So for each day, you have to submit the attendance by clicking on the checkboxes and submitting the update button. So if a participant has attended one session, you can click on the update button, and then the participant will get a mail that is absent for the remaining sessions. And you can click on here. Click here to download the PDF of the attendance sheet. On the start of the day, you can click on it. You will get a click on it. You will see. This PDF will be generated automatically for each day. You have to download it, get it signed from the participants, and upload it at the end of the day. So you have to select a date for uploading a day's scanned copy. So if you, after selecting the day, you can upload the day's PDF in this page. Yeah, scan and save it as PDF. We are allowing PDF formats till 1 MB. So this update button will vanish after 2 days, 48 hours, and the participants will receive a mail on their status at that particular day. This is the workshop coordinator's module, and you will see this when the main workshop is going on. Thank you.
Ma'am, in case if the participant want to change the remote center, is it possible? Maybe after 3 or 4 days of the course, after commencement.
That is not possible. After 3 or 4 days, it's not possible. He or she has to make up his mind before the workshop starts.
Once it commences, then
no changing.
Thank you, ma'am.